Before we are going to discuss about citizen series, my name is Patrick.
My name is Melissa.
My name is Muhammad Ilyas.
My name is Muhammad Ariel.
My name is Muhammad Farhan.
There are two types of series. The first one is an arithmetic series. And the second one is a geometric series. The arithmetic one is like if we have a sequence of 1, 2, 3, 4, the end sum starts from 1. And this, and the series is 1 plus 2 plus 3. And 1 we can determine as x1, s, and 2 is x2, where s2 is 2 plus 1, equals to 2. If in geometry we multiply it, like with example we have a sequence of 1, 2, 3, 4, and in geometry, we have a sequence of 1, 2, 4, 8, where the n starts from 2 times n, for example. And then we have an infinite series. And an infinite series is determined by the equation of s to a 1 minus r, where the ratio or r, if it's less than 1, we use this equation. But if the r is more than 1, we have the equation of s a r minus 1. Series is an ordered arrangement of real numbers for each positive integers. More formally, an infinite sequence is a function whose domain is the set positive of integers of whose range is a set of real numbers. By definition, the sequence of an an is said to converge when L we write as lim n towards 1. Infinity, where an equals to L. And for each positive number of E, there is a corresponding positive number of N. Then N is bigger than N equals to absolute of AN, as L is less than epsilon.
So in order to do this, we need to divide everything by n squared. So like this become 3, whereas this become 1, so this n squared. So, because this one is to infinite, or n close to infinite, that's when it will become 0. Therefore, the answer of this one will be 3 over 7. However, in this case, this limit will be divided by n, so it become because n is getting closer to infinite, that's when the answer will be 0. Therefore, the answer for this will be 3. That's all.
A positive series is a series with terms that are all positive. There are many tasks to prove whether the series converges or diverges. The first task is bounded sum test. The second one is integral test. The third one is p-series test. And number four is ordinary comparison test. Number five is limit comparison test. Number six is ratio test. And the last one is the root test.
This problem right here is an example of the positive series sequence, I mean positive series. And we will test it, so if it's converge or diverge. So to solve this, first we are going to use the ratio test, which is by using this formula an plus 1 over an, and we will apply it to this problem right here, so we get 2n plus 1 over n plus 1 and times Yes, I know, plus I know this one, so and over to N. And then we can write this one to, since this is basically with our
Now, we move the restriction and allowing some terms to be negative. In particular like this, we study the alternating series. So as you can see, alternating series has alternating signs. So if you have A1, it will be plus A2, minus A3, plus A4, and so on. And this will be equal to An. And if An is larger than 0, this is is for or n. The Sn minus S is equals to An plus 1. And we move the An plus 1 to 0. So if An is larger than An plus 1, is larger than 0. So the limit of An to the n infinity is 0. Then the series is convergent. Now we move to the example. So for example, we have a 1 minus a half plus 1 per term minus 1 4 plus the limit and so on. The alternating harmonic series satisfies the hypothesis of the theorem A and so it converges. So if 1 A, so we want the S and second one equals to A and plus 1, but then while it is smaller than 0, but 0 and 1, this will hold such as an plus 1 is equals to 1 per n plus 2, as an plus 1 is the series of it. So we require that it satisfies the n larger than 99. Thus, we need to take 99 terms to make sure that we have the desired accuracy. This gives you an idea of how the alternating harmonic series converges. So, as you can see, this series